Shiny invasive species are hitching rides on boats and causing problems across Texas. We're talking about zebra mussels. They've infested the lakes labeled in red on this map, killing native species and clogging water pipes on Lakes Texoma, Ray Roberts, Louisville, Bridgeport Levon, and Lake Belton. The spots marked in orange show other Texas waterways where mussels have also turned up. Starting tomorrow, a new regulation will make boaters take an extra step to keep the zebra mussels from spreading. KXAN's Sophia Beausoleil explains what that new rule means for you.
Officials say places like Lake Austin and Lake Travis are fine. The Texas Parks and Wildlife Department says people must drain their boats to help prevent the spread of zebra mussels and other problematic species.
These are what zebra mussels look like. Tiny shells with stripes on them that can produce up to a million microscopic larvae. They cling onto boats, trailers, buoys, and anything that sits in the water for a long time. They can clog pipes, damage engines, and in the end cost you a lot of money to fix. We spoke with a woman who just moved here from Minnesota who says they had similar regulations.
The wardens are there. They're looking at your boat when you come out of the water. And you drain it and you rinse it. And there's certain areas you can't go, like from one river to another, without really being careful.
In order to combat the invasive species, officials say you need to clean your boat and remove any vegetation, zebra mussels, and foreign objects. You need to drain all the water from the motor, the bilge, live wells, and bait buckets before leaving the lake. Finally, dry the boat and trailer for a week before going into any other water. And if that's not an option, use a high-pressure washer and hot, soapy water that reaches at least 140 degrees. And there's a lot more to this when it comes to just how zebra mussels impact the water. You can go to our website, KXAN.com, to learn more. Reporting from Lake Austin, Sophia Beausoleil, KXAN News.
And we have also learned the game warden will enforce these rules and also educate the public.